Welcome to the Invested Agents Podcast. I'm here with Manuel Carlos de la Huerga. Did I pronounce that right?
Yes.
Good. My wife's half Colombian. So, I mean, she'd be able to roll that in very well. But it's been a pleasure. So I got to know you a little bit a few months ago. So Manuel actually was one of the very first real estate agents to join eXp Realty Spain when they launched in Spain. And that's how we got connected. And just kind of want to talk a little bit about your business and your experience with the real estate market there and also eXp. So what does your business look like today? What is the main focuses that you have in your real estate business today?
Yes, my focus today is to list good properties, attractive properties for buyers, for investors. And if you see my place in eXp Spain, you will see 10 apartments of new development in Barcelona, in the center of Barcelona, in the best places of Barcelona. Starting at 595,000 euros, starting there, and reaching almost 1,290,000 euros. So, what I'm focused now is in list this. This type of properties.
Okay, so I did the quick conversion. So that's roughly 600,000 US to well over a million US dollars. So that's a high price point. And it is the market in Spain. So in the United States, inventory is very low. There's a lot of buyers. And in some cases, there can be bidding wars. And a lot of competition to get homes. Is that what you're experiencing in Spain, or is it different?
No, there is a huge competition here. It's huge. If you enter a portal of properties here in Spain, you see one apartment is promoted by six, seven, even eight real estate companies. So I found it, how come? I don't like this type of business, no. I want to be exclusive and I want to have a beautiful property, attractive to one buyer, no?
That's, of course, that makes things simpler and probably easier to move. So how did you get started in real estate?
I got started in real estate in Dominican Republic when I lived there.
All right.
Yeah. That's my first experience in real estate business. Before that, I was in the pharmaceutical industry, and then it comes the time that I want to be all by myself. I didn't have a pharmaceutical company by myself, but real estate gave me the opportunity to be alone, to have the time to administrate my time, to do what I am passionate in is to sell, and I started to do business in Punta Cana.
Wow.
an apartment project near the beach.
Yeah, so I mean you're dealing with some popular destinations, so Dominican Republic, Punta Cana, Barcelona. These are all very very good travel destinations, and Barcelona in itself is a large city and also a large tourist destination. So how has that experience been working in those kind of places?
I enjoy it. I enjoy it very much because, for example, as you say, in Barcelona, we have many foreign investment, and the market is growing now. It's in complete growth. For example, there was a lady from other company, real estate company. IAD is from it's a company from France. They listed a hotel, a complete hotel in the center of Barcelona, and she offered me to collaborate with her to look for a buyer and see if we can collaborate. So I'm in the process of list this property too.
Oh wow! So,
it's a real good investment because it's in the middle of Barcelona in a very good place, and you can have 50 rooms. The hotel complete is 50 rooms with parking underground, and you can have all the building in 12,500,000 euros. So it's a good price. It's a very good price. And as you say, I'm lucky. I was born in Dominican Republic. It's a very touristical place. My father was from Asturias at the north of Spain. So that's why I have the Spanish nationality since I was born. So at the end of my life, I'm here in Barcelona.
All right. And hey, if y'all didn't hear that, if you're looking for a hotel to invest in Barcelona, I've got one for you.
Yeah.
You mentioned foreign investors or foreign buyers. So in the United States, like China is one of the largest foreign buyers, especially in places like California. What nationalities are you seeing investing in Barcelona or in Spain?
Yes, the most of all is China, because we have here a law that offers you, if you invest in a property here more than 200,000 euros, you get the golden visa. The golden visa is you can live here in Spain, any place. So Chinese are very, very, is the most, I think the most investors we have here is the Chinese. We have also from Pakistan,
okay,
and Israel, Turkey, not too much Arabians, but some.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And English guys like to buy properties here in the beach.
Okay. Yeah. They're second home.
Yeah, obviously.
So what is your, or you reached out to me once eXp had announced opening up in Spain. What was it about eXp that attracted you to look into that opportunity more?
Yes, it's because I can be independent. I can administrate my time. I have all the resources I need because the CRM we have is very, very friendly and allow me to operate my business very comfortable.
How does the model compare? Because so in the United States, the model is drastically different in the sense that we're in the cloud, but as an agent, we can do all the things that we normally do. We get paid more, we get more resources. I know in other countries, real estate and the way real estate is conducted, it's very different. Mm-hmm. How does the way that eXp operates, how does it differ from traditional real estate companies in Spain?
Yes, it's very, very different. Very different because traditional companies use their office. You have to go there. You have to be there to use the CRM. You cannot use it from outside most of the time, and it's very easy.
Okay. So a lot of control. It seems like that other companies are very controlling and restrictive, and you found more flexibility with eXp.
Yes, exactly, just like that.
How's your experience been so far over these past few months?
The past few months, I'm very happy. We have a meeting all Mondays, and we discuss everything in the chat, and also we suggest to make changes, for example, to the documentation, to many things, and we discuss it. As soon we propose something, they studied it and they apply it to the daily business.
That's one of the luxuries of being one of the founding agents too. In Spain, is you were essentially your input is highly valued because you're one of the first agents there, and as it grows, so will your influence both in the community and with eXp Spain, and you've been able to influence some of those decisions and help the company grow. What is your real estate business? What does that look like over the next maybe 2-3 years from now?
Well, I expect to sell at least six properties a year,
including a hotel, right?
Including the hotel, yes. No, I wrote to a friend of mine who lives in Miami. He operates a few hotels in Dominican Republic, in Serbia, in Mexico, and he told me, well, now the hotel business is down, but maybe he can get me someone to interested in investing in Barcelona. No? Barcelona,
yes,
is a good place, but Barcelona is a very good place to invest in that. In tourist is the best in Spain.
Is Airbnb, is that popular in Barcelona?
Yeah, very much. Yeah.
I've seen some investors take small hotels and turn them into Airbnbs.
Yep.
Okay. Right. Just a couple quick questions. I ask these to everyone. We just kind of in closing, these are simple questions that I ask to everyone that I interview. If you could give advice to your 20-year-old self, what would that be?
Wow, don't work for anybody. Work alone.
All right, work for yourself.
Yeah. Put a business, anything, even a small business. You can operate your small business. For example, I don't know if I told you, but my son, studied economy, then he goes to political economy as a master, and then he start working with a company that administrates buildings. I mean, all the cleaning of the community areas and everything. And then now he's only 30 years old and he has his own company.
Own
company. Yeah, and he's in Valencia, here in Spain. And my daughter is a psychology. She's starting also with Instagram, and she's planning. She started now. She started to do online consultation, psychotherapy, etc.
That's the world we live in now.
Yeah.
So what book or books have greatly influenced your life?
Send to the Mind.
Sail
to the Mind.
Sail to the Mind.
Yeah, to the Mind. Yeah.
Sail to the Mind.
I don't know if it's the title in the United States.
I think I see it here. I'll send you a message and make sure I have the right one. And then I'll put it in the notes for folks to look at. In the last 5 years, what new belief, behavior, or habit has most improved your life?
Make exercise. Yes, because when I like to run in open spaces, mm-hmm. right? And it gives me the opportunity to think while I'm making exercise and to plan my day. I start to exercise in open spaces 6 years ago, and give me another perspective of life. And when I'm doing exercise, I can plan my day. I can think in things to do. And
you get a lot of time to yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah. I do the same thing. I'm a runner. Some of my best ideas come on the run.
Yep.
I just have to remember to write it down when I get back. Okay. Last one, how can people reach out to you? Feel free to leave that in English and Spanish, but how can folks reach out to you?
How
would you like people to reach out to you?
Oh, by any way, I have my email, I have my WhatsApp, Signal, Telegram. By phone, you can call me anytime, and I'm able to. I don't have any particular preference in that way.
Okay.
You can write me whatever.
All right, I'll put your contact info in the show notes so people can reach out to you. And any last thoughts or advice or anything?
Advice anything, because the company is growing now. Even here in Spain, we start a few months ago, and we are more than 60 people now in Spain. So keep encourage people to join us, and I will start to do that soon.
And
I will start to do that
soon. Just take note, because 60 today, this time next year,
yeah,
who knows, maybe 160.
Yeah.
And then 400.
Yeah.
And then 1500. Yeah. It all starts with one, though.
Yeah. I will start to recruit people now this month. I'm planning this with my daughter. Has a training in social media and everything, she's helping me. Wednesday we have she came and took me photos for my profiles and everything, and she's going to help me in that mission.
Of course. Hey, yeah. And actually, you can have her reach out, or if you want to send an email, because we can plug them into the team with Connor. So folks, like Connor Steinbrook is one of our business partners, and because that's Connor's specialty is social media and building social media, video marketing, and happy to see how we can help. So I'm looking forward to working with you over the years, and just let me know if I can do anything. Folks that want to reach out, if you're anywhere in the Spain area, or if you're looking to buy in Spain, if you're looking to grow your business, real estate business in Spain, or in the surrounding areas, reach out to Manuel and he'd be happy to assist. So thank you so much.
Thank you to you. Thanks to you, Chris.
Take care.
Have a good day.
You too.